As far as MLW is concerned, the rumors came out about how there could be that feeder system there potentially between WWE and MLW. Now, I think those rumors broke after we spoke last week. Do you think there is smoke to that fire of WWE wanting to work with MLW? Because I hear all these reports about, oh, WWE wants to break the stigma of that they can't work with anyone. I don't think they give a shit, so I don't really believe that report. But what say you? Do you think we could see that working relationship at some point, especially with MLW being on TV? Because I feel like they don't really need WWE as much as like Evolve did a couple of years ago.
Yeah, I mean, I think it would be great. I mean, I don't watch them a lot, but I mean, especially with Melissa Cornette, it sounds like they have a decent amount of young guys or just new faces that you could put in the WWE or NXT and kind of replenish the pot. I mean, I love NXT, but I feel like having a lot of the same kind of guys just kind of hanging around. The tag team division on pretty much any of their shows is kind of just meh. They haven't really, like, built anyone up really that new. Like, all the NXT guys, I feel like they bring them up. They don't really do much with them. So maybe bringing in these other guys could kind of, I mean, at the end of the day, they could bring them in and do nothing. But I feel like if they're working for another company, and like I said, maybe if they have Brian involved and somehow like give them a little bit of juice, I don't know. I think they have some talent that they could be utilizing better. And like I said, they just need a little facelift. I feel like WWE does. So putting in some new talent, I think it never hurts. But just kind of, I guess booking in the right way always is kind of the end of the day. But I think it'd be. It can't really hurt them, so at this point, Raw can't get any worse, I don't think, so.
Yeah, there's actually been a lot of great talents that have come out of MLW and that have gone to NXT over the years. Isaiah Swerve Scott being one of them, Shane Strickland a couple of years ago when he signed with WWE. Other than Jacob Fatu, is there anyone there right now that you know of that you think would be a good fit for WWE at some point?
I mean, the Von Erichs would be great.
No, the Von Erichs, yeah, that's a great pick, yeah. Yeah,
Ross and Marshall, they could use them, the tag team division. Haven't seen a lot of them, but Cornette talks about Hammerstone.
Yeah, Alex Hammerstone.
I mean, talks about him like he's like the next big thing. So, I mean, haven't seen much of him, but I mean, that sounds like it'd be pretty cool. I mean, he sounds like he's a star potential. And I mean, he talks about Fatu like he's like Roman Reigns already. So, I mean, we could say, but no, I mean, I really think some young guys they could definitely implement and kind of replenish the pot a little bit.
Would that mean that we get Loki back in NXT?
Oh, God, I hope not. He's in the MLW? Jesus, Christmas.
I don't know if he still is. He was at one point. They have him. Leo Rush being... I don't know if that would mean that Leo Rush would be back, because Leo Rush is there right now killing it. Austin Aries was doing work with him for a while, but I'm pretty sure he's retired or something.
He's too busy being a non-vaxxer, so who knows?
No, he's too busy denying that it's real or some shit. Did you see that shit this is completely off topic, but did you see that controversy with him a couple of months ago? And this pains me as a fan of Aries. I mean, I guess former, I'm not really a fan of him now, but did you see that thing with him a couple of months ago where he was like, it was some sort of meet and greet like WrestleCon, it wasn't WrestleCon, but it was something like that. And he was saying that if you go to meet him, he doesn't want you wearing a mask. Unless I'm completely, you know, misinterpreting the situation. I'm pretty sure it said that if you come to meet me, I don't want you wearing a mask. Like, you would think it'd be the opposite, but that's literally what he said because he doesn't think it's real and it's going to make people afraid or blah, 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 blah. Like, how fucking weird is that?
Yeah, I think it was like a thing. It was like if you took a picture with him, you had to take your mask off or some stupid ass. I don't know. He's a fucking lunatic.
Yeah, so hopefully he's not in MLW anymore, but have you heard the name of Filthy Tom Lawler by any chance?
I've heard the name, yes.
I think he was there. I don't know if he's there now. I've heard good things about him, too. Contra Unit, I think they're pretty good from what I've heard. Again, if Dario Cueto is in MLW and they can get him in NXT, take my fucking money. A William Regal, Dario Cueto face-off between the authority figures, I would need that ambulance that just drove by you 5 minutes ago. Who was the other one? They have a bunch of people on that roster. They have a very good roster overall. Loki was there at one point. Oh, man. Like you said, Jacob Fatu, he's a good one. Alex Hammerstone's a good one. There was someone else that I was thinking of. I don't remember at the moment. But, yeah, I think any working relationship between the two companies would be cool. Because, again, Evolve is in the toilet. They signed a bunch of their people that they're just not even using, which is weird. So, I don't know. I guess we'll see as it plays out. But I'm interested to see if there is any truth to it. I currently don't think there is. But seeing is believing with WWE.